Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Coming to the internal affairs of the country, Madam Deputy Chairman, the policies of the Government of India for the last 15 years have been so manipulated that the rich people are becoming richer and the poorer sections of the people are becoming still poorer. The committee that has been appointed to investigate into the question of the distribution of income has not yet given its verdict, but it is common knowledge that the people who are in the higher ups have become more rich and the people in the lower rung have become poorer. The prices of essential commodities that the peasants and the workers use have gone up so high that they are not within the reach of the mass of the people of the country. Government have not taken adequate steps to bring down the prices and to stabilize the prices as was recommended by the Food Grains Committee. We are now in the third plan. While the plans are progressing, the number of the unemployed in the country is increasing. This is a very anomalous position. It is the government alone that can explain why, in spite of the plans, the unemployment problem is becoming more and more acute, as was rightly pointed out yesterday by some speakers. Our agriculture has not been paid due attention that should have been paid to in a country where 80% of the people live on land. Some 3 or 4 years back, when Mr. Ajit Prasad Jain was the Food and Agriculture Minister, he was made to resign under shady circumstances as one who had proved not capable of solving the food problem in the country. A suggestion was thrown that the portfolio of agriculture should be handled by an important and senior member of the cabinet, and particularly in the states, by the chief ministers of the states, but nothing of the sort has happened. Whatever increase in food grains outputs we have obtained is not because of any increase in the yield per acre, but because of extensive cultivation. More land has been brought under cultivation and some irrigation facilities have now been provided, but the increase that we have seen is not in keeping with the demand that is necessary for us to feed 400 millions in India. So whatever industrial development we want, the basic factor is that our agricultural economy should be improved. Stop.